Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. Okay, so this question belongs to GATE CSC 2005. Okay, so the given question is, consider the following message. Okay, so they gave the message what we want to transfer. Okay, the cyclic redundancy check. So we are using cyclic redundancy check for this particular message using the divisor. They gave an equation. Okay, so while solving this question, so you can solve in two different ways, guys. If you are good with working with the polynomials, you can directly use the concept of polynomials, but for me, I will be doing some silly mistakes, guys. So that is the reason why I am going to solve it directly with bitwise only. So basically, what is our message? It is 1 0 1 0 0 1 1 0 1. Okay, and what is our divisor here? It is a nothing but x power 5 plus x power 4 plus x square plus 1. So if you recall how we can convert it, guys. So we are having 1x power 5, 1x power 4, 0x power 3, 1x power 2, 0x power 1, and 1 is 1. So basically this is our divisor indirectly. So basically here what you will do is, so you will start mapping, guys. So x power 0, x power 1, x power 2, x power 3, x power 4. So basically what are in yours, you will place 1s there and rest all you will place 0. So in that way it will work, okay. So the same logic I have applied here also. Sorry, I think previously this was not visible, right? Let me revise it. So basically you will write in this way, guys. So basically x power 0, x power 1, x power 2, x power 3, x power 4 and so on. So whichever are in your list, you will write 1s there and which are not available, you will place 0. So that is your binary representation for that polynomial expression. Got it? Yes. So let us continue. So now we got this equation, right? Yes. And one more important thing is, never forget to add zeros here, guys. Because if you follow the normal traditional polynomial method, I will forget this particular step, guys. So that is the main reason why I will use this binary method, because it is a bit easy for me. Okay. Yes. So basically how many bits are here, guys? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 are there. So I will be subtracting 1. So the result is 5. So I will add 5 extra zeros here, guys. 4, 5. So basically few students will be like, what exactly are these 5? So basically if you recall, whenever you are transferring some particular message to control error, along with message, we will send some redundant bits, right? So these are the exact 5 redundant bits. So in options also, you will find those 5 redundant bits which we want to find also. Got it? Yes. So let us start. So basically both first 1s are matching. So it is 1s are 1 1 0 1 0 1. So remember one more thing, we are going to apply XOR operation, guys. So if both are same, you will get the result as 0, and if both are different, you will get 1. Okay, yes. So one bit will be brought down. Similarly, now it is again 1s are only. So it is 1 1 0 1 0 1 0 0 sorry it is same so 0 different same. Okay, so again this one will come down. Nice. So it is a zeros are now. Okay. It is a 1 1 1 0 1. This zero will come down. Nice. So it is a ones are. It is a 1 1 0 1 0 1. Okay. So these two guys will go out. So it is a zeros are, ones are. It is a 1 1 1. So basically just by observation also you can say, right? Yes. So now one will come down. Okay. So you will do zeros are and you will get all zeros here. These two guys will go out. Ones are, ones are, ones are, ones are, ones are. Nice. I'm not doing any silly mistakes, right? Because I always get a doubt, like whenever these kind of patterns will be coming, I'll be a bit skeptical about it, guys. Because, okay, so I did a mistake here. So, okay, so this zero has come here and this one has come here. Okay, so it's correct only. So just to give me a second, I'm getting a doubt here. So let me cross check it once again. Okay, so everything looks correct, guys. I was a bit skeptical about it. Okay, so anyway, let us continue. So it is a 0, 0, you will be coming down. So again, let us continue. 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. Okay, so these two guys will go out. 0, different, 0, different, different. So this 0 will be coming down. Okay, so you can do 0. So guys, this part, if you stop writing also, there is no issue. But don't do silly mistakes, guys. That's all. Because I thought I did some silly mistake, but it's correct only, I think so. So let us continue. Again, it will be 1s are, so it is 1 1 0 1 0 1. Okay, so these two guys will go out. 1s are, 1s are, 0 0 1. Okay, so the last second 0 is coming here now. So it is 1 1 0 1 0 1. Guys, if you are having a doubt like how exactly I was solving this much fastly, just to cross check the video where we have discussed the CRC concept, guys, because I explained you about the concept, right? So how exactly you can solve it. So it will be 0s are. Okay, so 0 0 0 0 0. So at the end we got these two guys will cancel out. So it is a 0, 1, 1, 0. So this is our pattern. So is there any option like that? Yes. So option A is the correct answer. Got it? Yes. It's a quite easy question, guys. The only question, this question is a directly dependent on the in the topic CRC, right? So they gave an expression and they are asking the redundant bits. So what are the redundant bits? Got it? Yes. So now I hope everyone got a clear idea, right? Yes. So the basic division, we use XOR operation here, guys. So to match these strings. So basically, if both are same, you will get a 0. If both are different, you will get 1. So that is the exact logic with respect to XOR. Okay. Yes. And how many bits are here? So among that, do minus 1 and add them as redundant bits. Got it? Yes. So now you are getting the idea, right? Yes. Exactly how we are solving it. Okay. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.